Hello everyone and welcome to another product introduction video. My name is Oliver Draper, CTO at 4COP, and the product I've got to show today is the brand new Hikvision IP PoE Horn Speaker. This one is a 7-watt speaker, hence why it can be powered by PoE. They do another one which is a 25-watt one, again can't be powered by PoE because the amount of power it's required. This device has also got built-in microphones, it also supports two-way audio. It's got built-in storage. Got a web browser to it, so you can web browser into it. You can upload audio files onto there, get about gigs of a storage on there, you can put onto there. Even has a voice synthesis engine in there as well, so you can do a text to talk platform as well, so you can text in what you want to say and it can speak that phrase out in either male or female voice. Set schedules when it plays a certain audio file or it says a certain phrase as well. Also has a SIP protocol in there as well, so it does support adding it to your SIP servers and all the other things like that. Can be added to Hike Central, also can be added to the Hike Connect app as well. So again, it'll work on the app and you can even use that for two-way audio should you wish as well. So again, a really effective bit of kit. So what we'll do, we'll get it plugged in, we'll get it powered up, log into it and just see what we can do with it. So here we are on SADP, that little bit of software that you download the Hike website, which is used to obviously discover Hikvision device on the network and activate and change the IP details. At the very bottom here is we've got our horn speaker, which is showing as inactive at the moment. So there it is, DS-QAZ1307G1T-E-E, indicating it's a PoE speaker. The 7 before the G1 indicates it's a 7-watt speaker. So we'll just tick it there on the right hand side. I'm just going to give this a password of my choice, as I would do for any other Hikvision device. Pop it in once and pop it in twice. Okay, and click activate. Once I've activated it, next thing I'm going to do is then change the IP details because that is not appropriate for my network. It has got DHCP as an option, which I am going to use. Tick that. Again, pop the password in and click modify, and therefore that's now changed the IP details, so that will now work on my network. Again, you don't need to use DHCP, you might want to give it a fixed IP address. Again, that comes down to your local network requirements. So we'll just wait for that to update. I'm just gonna hit refresh, and hopefully when that appears now, there we go, that's now got a suitable IP address. Double click the IP address, and we're straight into the web browser of the horn speaker. As you can see there by the pictures, we know we're in a sound device. Also gives you a little indication as well of the other speaker devices that Hikvision have actually launched as well. They have got ceiling speakers and column speakers of our more they have as well. Future videos will appear on that one. So now what I do, I'm just gonna log in with the details. So admin is username, password is the password that I obviously gave the device just a second ago. Click login. I don't want to say the password. And as you can see, it's using the new web browser interface that a lot of the newer Hikvision devices are starting to adopt. As you start updating the firmware on all your Hike devices, you'll see that they're all starting to adopt this new layout. As you see at the top there, we're showing we've got a connection for a wide status, which is fine. It does support ISUP. ISUP is where we can get the device to call into a server of some sort. Could be Hike Central. And also there, you notice Hike Connect Offline. So yes, this has got the facility to be added to the Hike Connect app. Another thing as well, which we're going to talk about, it also has built-in microphone. So it does support two-way audio through the actual horn speaker as well. Also has the SIP service in there as well. So again, it can be added to your standard SIP service as well. So we're going to go to the left-hand side and go to configure, and we're just going to see some of the things that we can do with this device. Under system configuration, yeah, give the normal system details like you would do with any other Hikvision device. At the top there, we've got our time settings. Yes, because obviously Hikvision is a Chinese product, it does default to China time. I'm just going to just sync with computer time, just make our life a lot easier. And there we go, straight away, bang, it's put us in the correct time zone, and it's also configured the date and time to today as well. And then just click save. Fairly straightforward. On the left-hand side, user management. Yep, just like any other Hikvision device, you can have different users, have different access to the device if you wanted to. Your network details, which again, we've already configured this stuff via SADP. Your network services are using HTTP, HTTPS. You want to change the port number, you can do. And the working mode. So I'm using ISUP. If you are using ISUP, you can enable the ISUP feature just here. I'm using the Hike Connect feature. If you are, you turn on the Hike Connect feature, put in your verification code and get it to your Hike Connect app. Or I'm using the SDK service. That is where you can change the port number, depending on what sort of software service it's going to go into. Left hand side there again, we got audio and we got the mic input volume and we got the output settings as well. Now this horn speaker has the capability of being a 121 decibels is the maximum, and that sound pressure level is what that gives us. That's very loud. It's as loud as potentially a little bit louder than what a motorcycle engine would be when that's revving up. It's a very loud device. So again, do make sure you have a changes depending on what your requirements actually are as well. You might want to reduce it down so you're not actually having it too loud. I'm just going to put mine down just a fair bit. It is on the desk next to me. I don't want to bust my eardrums on this thing. At the top there, we have got the speaker test. You can click that button and it does a test and it plays like an audio file that's already built into the speaker itself. We'll just leave that for the time being. On the left side, going down a bit further, we got our SIP information. So again, if we are going to add it to our SIP server, this is where we put all our SIP details in there. So again, what the username, password, the display name is going to be, and then the SIP details of your SIP server as well. So it can be added directly to that. And then left-hand side again, broadcast settings. This is where we can input our media library. If you look on the right hand side there, 1024 megabytes. So again, you've got about a gig of space on this to actually upload your own audio files. It says that at the top, upload audio file in MP3, WAV, and it has to be less than 100 meg each. So again, you know, you're talking about a good 10 files if they have 100 meg each. And 100 meg for an audio file is quite a large file as well. Again, considering what you're going to be using this for, this is a horn speaker. You could use it to broadcast music over and things, or you can just have your pre-recorded audio phrases. That's absolutely fine. You want to put them in there. As we go to the top, we've got schedule broadcast. So we go to add here. This is where we can have our different schedule to do different things. And as you can see, I can just add, save the current task first of all, of course. I can just put a task in here for a certain date and time to do various different things. So I can say play an audio file at this time. And on this time, at this date, and I just create whatever sort of schedule I want. Click on my advanced configuration. And each one I can say, is it an audio file or is it speech synthesis? I can type in my own phrase and it says a different thing at certain times as well. So it might be that if it's, if you're a retail outlet that's playing a certain music audio file, but then throughout the day you might have it speaking this particular phrase, advertising a certain product or whatever it is. It's entirely up to yourself. It could even be, I know, a school environment that might be just in the corridors playing some background noise, and every now and again it might just give an alert about not running in the corridors or whatever. You know, the limitations are limitless there, basically. It's entirely up to yourself. And don't forget, as you click for each one, you can change the volume of each one as well. So one might be louder than the other at different times of day. Is it going to play once? Is it going to loop that phrase that you're putting in there? So again, a really effective scenario, and you can have different scheduled broadcasts for different things. If I go across to my strategies one there as well, continue broadcast in next day. So as it says there, after the function enabled, the device will continue to play the next audio file on the list at the set time in the next day. So again, it will just continue that in there. So again, really effective. And then we've got our alarm configuration as well. So as I mentioned, on the back of the horn speaker, there is an alarm input, just a dry contact, that's all it is. And as soon as that dry contact is made, which in this case we can say, is our alarm going to be a normally open circuit or normally closed circuit? So we say it's normally open, yep, which it is now, nothing's connecting. Once that connection is made, that's when it's actually going to trigger the alarm. Or we could change that round if we want to actually say, as it's going to be an NC, so normally closed circuit, and again put our alarm name in there and set, is it instant or arming, or is it going to be basically armed only at a certain time of day? And then we've got our audio linkage, in which we can link to that as well, should we wish. So there's our alarm input. If I go to audio alarm linkage, it could be that when the alarm input is received, it plays a particular audio file, or it does a particular speech. It could be something like, I don't know, the word emergency. If I could spell that correctly, there we go. Let's get rid of that L out of there. There we go. It just says the word emergency. What sort of voice? Is it a male voice, female voice? It's entirely itself. Again, what volume do I want it to be? I'm going to reduce that right down because otherwise it's going to be quite loud. I'll just put that to 10. And just to play that once, and I just save that there. Army schedule. Yep, don't forget to edit that and put in there what you want your army schedule to actually be. Again, you've got your alarm input there as well to indicate, obviously, when that's going to be in effect. So again, I can say it's going to be instant arming, and I'll just turn that on for my entire one just there. Audio linkage, save that. That's now saved. Hasn't got a name, but again, you can give it a name should you wish. So technically, when that connection is bridged now, it will just say the word emergency. Let's just do that. Let's just bridge that connection, just see what that sounds like. So I've got the horn in front of me here. On the back, we have got our alarm input there. Let's move these to one side. I'm just going to pop that on the desk. And I'm just going to bridge the connection just using a piece of wire because it is only a dry contact, just to see what this actually does. So let's just try this out. And that's at level 10 for the volume. It's not too bad. Let's just increase that a bit. Well, I may not go that high. Let's go to 40. Let's save that. Let's see what this is like now. So as we see there, as soon as it bridged the connection there with that, it was triggering that speech phrase just to the word emergency. And as you can see, it could be anything you want to. Gives you multiple characters to use. You can see that at the bottom. As soon as you start typing, it tells you how many characters you've got. I'm using one out of a possible 8,192 characters I could put in there. So again, it can say any number of different phrases. So under schedule broadcast, let's take a look and see what we can do in here then. So as we talked about, yeah, material library, I can import and upload our different audio files I want to do there. If we go to schedule broadcast, let's just create a schedule. Let's give this a go. And we'll go with speech synthesis again. We'll go to, let's just do a few days. What are we on today? I always lose track of days. We're on Tuesday today. I'm going to Tuesday already. Okay, so let's just put that to there. Let's put it to the time where we are at the moment. And that's going to be, so we'll come to 12 o'clock. So we'll just pass 12. Should be, we'll just click on it. And let's set this at 12. What are we on? 12:05 at the minute. Let's go 12:07. Just give us enough time to do what I need to do. Click OK. Advanced configuration. What I wanted to say. Welcome to COP. Volume. I'm not going to have 100. That's going to be far too loud. But I'm just going to go for something around about 36, 35, that should be fine. And I just want to play it once as well. So I'll just click save on there. Save that there. That's now saved. So at the minute, it's showing 12:06 on my clock now. So hopefully in a moment, let me just take it out of time to see what it's saying. In hopefully not too long, in a minute, it will just say, welcome to COP. And there we go. We got the welcome to COP there. I did fast forward that little pause I was waiting for just for the time to keep up. I know you guys only just sit there waiting for 20, 30 seconds for that time to catch up ourselves. Again, very effective. We just put one in there just for that brief one. But with this is a weekly schedule. We could have it as a daily schedule if we really wanted to as well. So does it per day or do it by week? And as you saw, we can just add in more schedules to do more things at different ones, and we can choose which schedule we want it to actually be in effect, essentially. So a really effective bit of kit in order to be able to just trigger these pre-recorded phrases or trigger these audio files that we actually wanted to do. So there we go, everyone. Really effective bit of kit, and as you saw there, dead straightforward and dead easy to actually configure and set this up. Up to 121 decibels of sound pressure this thing can project. Do be mindful, that is very loud. Anything above 110 decibels can permanently damage your earrings. So do be careful when setting these up and not being too close to it. As you saw from my demonstration, I was turning the volume right down when I was doing quick tests of these things. 121 decibels of sound pressure, that's the equivalent of a motorcycle engine revving away and things. And it's quite loud. You're talking bulldozer sort of engines. You know, that's quite loud just from a device of this sort of size. And this is only the 7-watt speaker version. Do have a 25 watt version as well if you needed something bigger. There are other devices coming as well. Again, videos will follow on that. We have got network column speakers coming, network ceiling speakers. So Hikvision are launching a full audio range as well. Again, we will do more videos of when they do come out. If you are interested in this device, go to the description below. All our contact details are there to actually inquire about this device. It is available for pre-order. They are on the way into stock as we speak. Hope you liked the video. If you did, as always, please do leave a like. Don't forget to subscribe. And if you hit that bell icon, you'll be alerted to upload any new videos.